Now that our code is inside a function, it has to be called, otherwise it won't work. So let's invoke our code right after we define it. Now first I'm going to give myself a little bit more space here so you can see what I'm writing. And if we call display work and save it and refresh the page, we can see that our work experience appears right here.
So James, when you wrote display work, you didn't put an argument in. You didn't pass in a parameter. That's pretty interesting. Why didn't we have to use one?
Well, this function is using an object that's in the global scope for the script, meaning it's accessible to the function, which is also in the global scope.
True. But let's imagine that we wanted to, for some reason, add multiple different work sections to the page. Then what would we need to do?
That sounds like a job for an argument. If this function took in an argument, we could pass it different work objects, which would each get displayed on the page.
You think we should do that?
I'm having a hard time imagining why you want to do that for this example. I have a better idea. Let's say you wanted to track where users are clicking on your site. We could collect the cursor location every time a user clicks on the page and send that off to our analytics site.
Interesting. Let's see how that works.